look at him.
Okay, I'm talking to H.L.
Sudler.
Sudler. And you are the author of From Man to Gentleman.
I am indeed.
And also this book called Patriarch. Tell me about, why don't you tell me something about your book, From Man to Gentleman, Beginner's Guide to Manhood.
So,
what gave you the idea?
I realized that young men don't know everything that they should know about being a man, and being a man takes education. It just is not intuitive. It is something that has to be learned. There are certain topics like sex and sexuality, money, empowerment, fitness, that are not intuitive. So you have to learn these things.
You want to give me some idea of different chapters in here?
So there is sex and sexuality. There is empowerment. There is money. There is image and wardrobe.
I know. I read something that said, don't wear a lot of jewelry on the job. What you do on your own time is your business.
Is your own business, which is exactly the truth. It is your own business. How do you come to your first job? You know, should you be on the phone all the time? Do you know how to compose a resume, your first resume? Do you know how to compose a cover letter? A lot of young guys do not know these things that are imperative. We often hear from our parents, save money, save money, save money, but they don't necessarily tell you what to do with the money once you've saved it to make more money. They just say save it.
What do you say in this book? What's your secret?
I say invest. Find ways to make your money, make more money. You two people should be working here. You and your money should be working, both, to make you more money. It's as simple as that.
Now, who buys this book?
So, the From Man to Gentleman book is mostly bought by women. So, women...
For whom?
So, they are buying it for their sons, nephews, brothers, any male that they may have in their life who they feel could benefit from an education on what it's like to be a man, they are buying it for them to educate them.
I don't peruse these kind of books, but is this a rather unusual book in that sense?
It is indeed a rather unusual book. And here's the thing. Often people will say they'll write a book like this, but they'll write it from a religious standpoint. Or they'll write a book and it's from a racial standpoint. In other words, you know, this book is just for black men, or this book is just for gays, or it's just for, you know, Muslims. And I'm like, no, all men are the same, basically. And all men have an education that they must learn in order to be a man.
Have you ever read Dale Carnegie's How to Win Friends and Influence People?
Yes, I have.
My father made me read that book.
And it's a very good book, too.
And I followed the rules, and I actually got elected group leader at but you know, he killed himself at 75 because he said simple things like, everyone loves a good listener.
Yes.
If I can compliment somebody, they're going to like you because...
Yes.
So essentially he's telling you to sort of like play phony games, like,
right.
You know.
Right.
Don't be honest and direct.
No. You must be honest. You must be direct.
Right.
Not mean direct,
right.
But
right.
Direct.
But people love a compliment. I mean, it's human nature.
Yes.
Even if I give you a legitimate criticism, you may appreciate the criticism.
Right.
But on a basic level, you don't like receiving that criticism.
Now, here's the thing. Often, and I've read the 1 Minute Manager as well, and in there they say, if you have something negative to say or criticism to say about someone, say it first and then follow it up with a compliment.
Oh, the 1 Minute Manager, is that a management book or?
That is a management book, probably written in 1975.
Oh. So is there any other book similar to this at all?
No.
What would you say this is aimed at men just, say, entering manhood?
I say fair game, 16 and up. And it talks about, again, it's very frank about sex and sexuality. It's very frank about, you know, first jobs and relationships and building a family. Everybody's at the table. Blacks, whites, Latinos, you know, big guys, thin guys, gay guys, straight guys.
What do you say about fat? I know that thin, fat guys always make a bad impression, like obesity. And also being tall makes a good impression. Do you say how to get past those obstacles?
Those, I don't see them as obstacles so long as you're a man. People will appreciate you if you are a man. So if you are a large man, being sure to be, you know, clean and hygienic and dressing well, then that helps you out. If you come unkempt and you're thin, no one's gonna like you either. So you have to, you know, come and bring your best self.
And where can people buy your book?
You can buy this book on Amazon, you can buy it on Barnes & Noble, you can get it through Goodreads.
Have you gotten any reviews on this?
I have, and people have liked it. Women.
Were the reviewers, were there any male reviewers?
No.
Only women.
Like,
only women want to talk about men telling other men how to be gentlemen.
Yes. I think they don't believe that conversation has been had enough.
And what do you think is the biggest shortcoming that straight men have, and say gay men also, I mean, or groups of men, pick any group?
I think straight men, if there's any shortcoming, is probably believing that every other man is like them. And for gay men, I would probably say the shortcoming is that it takes a long time to believe in yourself when you should believe in yourself. There's nothing about you that is less than any other man.
Well, how about when somebody say a nerd, a computer nerd? A lot of people are artistic or nerdy.
You know, when I was growing up, being a nerd was a bad thing. Now being a nerd is a very good thing. It means you're smart. And you're likely the one that I'm going to go to fix my computer.
So you give that a job. That's the one way to go from being a man to a gentleman.
Gentleman, indeed.
Being a nerd, knowing how to fix their computer.
Hey, knowing how to fix my computer or do something really wonderful that I don't know how to do.
Okay, well, thank you, H.L. Sudler.
Sudler.
From man to gentleman. I look forward to reading your book.
Thank you so much.